Hi, this is Paul Solt from iPhone to Have TV. Welcome to Swift and iOS 8 apps in 31 days. I'm very excited to start this new course. The course is going to follow a daily format with daily lessons. There's going to be a lot of recorded videos for you to watch and learn from, as well as challenges to really make sure that you're understanding the material. Now, this course is about Swift, which is Apple's new programming language, and it will teach you how to create apps for the latest version of the iPhone operating system called iOS 8. Let's go over what we'll be talking about in this video. So I'm going to show you what materials you'll need, the learning outcomes that you can expect, a little bit on the schedule, the topics, and how to get help. In terms of materials, you'll need a Mac 2008 or later. Now, I highly recommend a 2012 or later because it's going to be a lot faster and a better learning experience. If you don't have a Mac, you can still learn these materials and practice using a service called macandcloud.com, which costs $20 a month. In terms of software you need, it's free, it's Xcode 6, and it's Mavericks. You can use either of these and you'll be good to go. And the last thing I want you to have is a notebook or a sketch pad where you can take notes or you can write down questions as you're learning. The learning outcomes for this course are to teach you how to write Swift code. This is a hands-on course. You will be writing code throughout the course. And I highly recommend that as you're watching these videos, you're following along in Xcode because that's going to be the best way and the fastest way to learn how to make an iPhone app. You're also going to learn how to design user interfaces with Xcode. There's a drag and drop editor that makes it really easy to drag on buttons and labels and text boxes so that you can create the interfaces for your iPhone apps. And I think the most important part is I'm going to teach you how to learn. This isn't going to cover every single topic for iOS because there's a lot of topics, but it is going to get you started with programming if you've never programmed before, and it's going to show you how to learn the things that you don't know or how to figure out where you can go next for help. Our schedule is going to include daily lessons. Now, the target is around 1 hour a day. This is going to include lecture videos that are going to be around 20 minutes total. There might be shorter lecture videos. It might be a set of videos. So you can watch these on your time, fit them into your schedule. Then there'll be a code exercise where you'll get an activity. This is where you get the hands-on experience, and this is so crucial for learning. So if you want to write iPhone apps, you have to write code every day. Then we have the Q&A video. This is going to cover the common questions that students are asking, and this is going to be based on your emails or discussions that we have on the forum. And lastly, I want you to track progress as you're working through these materials. Each day, you should be writing down new terms that you've discovered, new terms that you don't quite understand, things that don't quite make sense. When you're doing this, leave some space. And then as you're working through the materials, you might learn something. Flip back a couple pages in your notebook, answer some questions in your own words. Rewording something in a language that you would write makes it a lot easier to understand what the topic or concept is. So go back, fill in the blanks that you don't understand after you start to uncover some of the puzzles of the after you start to uncover some of these puzzle pieces and connect them together. In terms of topics, you're going to learn programming basics in this course. So if you've never programmed before, this is a great place to start because I'm going to introduce you to concepts and I'm going to explain why you need them and how they're important in a published app that you might see on the App Store. You'll also learn how to do Xcode UI design using the interface designer or the interface builder. This is a drag and drop editor that allows you to arrange the components around the screen of an iPhone or an iPad. You'll learn how to integrate both code and UI so that when someone taps on a button, it does something. It maybe purchases something or it does a calculation for you. And then you'll learn how to integrate with the Cocoa Touch APIs. And this is something that is really important to understand because these APIs will not only allow you to make apps with Swift, but these are the same APIs you use to make apps in Objective-C. So learning how to leverage these will allow you to make apps regardless of what programming language you're using. Lastly, if you need help, there are two places you can get help. The first is the forum. This is forum.iphonedev.tv. Here you can ask questions, and I think it's also important to answer questions. So if you ask a question and you figure it out, answer your own question so that other people can figure out how to move forward, but also answer other people's questions, because this is, again, part of the learning process. When you start to explain a concept in your own words, you're going to remember it a lot better than if you just ask questions without answering questions. So use that as a learning technique. And lastly, if you need help, reach out to me at email. It's pulsesalt@iphonedev.tv. I read and respond to every email. I do get a lot of messages, so it might be a little bit slow, but I try to do it within a couple days so that you can keep on learning. All right, so thank you for checking out this course. Again, I've covered the materials. You'll need a Mac. I recommend a 2012 or later. You'll need Xcode 6, and we'll be targeting iOS 8 using the Mavericks or the upcoming Yosemite operating system. Your learning outcomes are really about learning how to learn, and I'm going to provide you the introductory material so that you can get started. And our schedule is going to be a daily format so that you can adapt the learning to your own schedule. If you want to learn 2 days a week, you can learn 2 days a week. If you want to learn 5 days a week, you can learn 5 days a week. You just need to build in time into your schedule so that you can learn effectively. We're going to introduce programming topics related to Swift that are going to show you how to work with the APIs in the iPhone SDK, along with how to connect your user interface to your code. And lastly, if you need any help, you can always reach out to me or get help on the forums. Thanks for taking a look at the upcoming course. Thank you for joining this course, and I look forward to helping you build your first iPhone app and getting it onto the App Store.